I might start with, I guess, some more positive news, if I can, and that is firstly just to acknowledge that we've had a very challenging set of circumstances in the last 24 hours at the Royal Children's Hospital. You'd be aware yesterday we reported a baby there, two parents and a healthcare worker had tested positive. I just wanted to advise that the latest advice that I have is that all the results have been received, bar one result that's still pending of the babies at the NICU, and they have all come through as a negative. So I think that is very good news, very positive news that I wanted to share with the community, because I know that this particular incident is one that would have caused a great deal of distress to many. And I want to take this opportunity to acknowledge the amazing staff who work at that NICU at the Royal Children's, who are incredibly dedicated and devoted to their patients, and to acknowledge, of course, the great distress that would have been experienced to all the families involved at the Royal Children's. So just in terms of aged care, as the Premier has indicated, look, we have been working very closely with the aged care sector and with the Commonwealth Government as the funder, as the regulator of the aged care system in Australia. We have had some very challenging circumstances, and I have to say personally, I have found the last week very distressing to see the number of outbreaks that we have had across our aged care sector in Victoria, and also the number of fatalities that we have had. And I want to acknowledge the grief of all of those families who have lost a loved one, a very much loved member of their family in recent days. So the situation in largely private aged care has been very, very concerning. And we have taken steps today and in recent days to support that sector and to support the Commonwealth Government's in its efforts. From last week, for example, we have had a very distressing situation at St Basil's in Fawkner. This is a facility that is very close, of course, to many members of the Greek community, and I know they have been particularly distressed to see the rising toll of deaths at that facility. So, I'm sorry. So from last week, there's a private provider that stepped in at St Basil's, brought in by the Commonwealth Government, pardon me. We stepped in with support staff there. The Northern Hospital has been very much involved. They've sent doctors.